Hi. That's me, Isidora Mujica, and I'm talking in English because the next speaker will be giving the communication, the short communication in English. Please welcome Andrea Heidenreich. Yeah, okay. So he's just the opposite profile as we have seen right now. He's a great example of a successful researcher, and well, he studied chemistry, as Mikkel said, and also he did his doctorate degree at University of Marburg. I'm all the time correcting my spelling in German. And he was dealing with quantum chemistry. And he continued his research in Tel Aviv for 15 years, 3 years more in Berlin, and then he came here. And since 2008, he's a Iker Vázquez researcher, which is one of the few ways remaining in Spain to be fully a professor and fully a researcher. And well, today he will be talking about the current research area, which is the study of plasma explosions in clusters of nanodroplets, yep, provided by short radiation. Okay, so nothing more, and thank you, Andreas, again.
Thank you for the kind introduction. In my presentation, I would like to give you a flavor for one branch of science, which is computer simulations in physics and chemistry. Computer simulations are found in almost every field of science and engineering. In my field, I'm interested in processes which happen when clusters are irradiated by extremely intense short laser pulses. A cluster, in Spanish, conglomerado or cúmulo, is a small droplet of atoms like here in this is a droplet of 6,000 xenon atoms. This is an apparatus to generate and to investigate clusters. You cannot fill clusters into a bottle. They live only for a short while, as long as they are in vacuum and do not collide with other matter, other clusters, or the wall of the experimental vessel. This is the laser optics. However, in my work, I do not deal with such apparatus. For me, the clusters and laser pulses exist only in computer programs. I'm going to show you a short movie of obtained from a computer simulation, what happens when this cluster here is irradiated by a short laser pulse. Yes, below you see the time axis with the oscillating electric field. Maybe you have learned at school that light is an oscillating electric and magnetic field, and the laser electric field is so strong that it can pull off electrons from the atoms. It can ionize atoms. The duration of the laser pulse is several tens of femtoseconds. 10 femtoseconds is extremely short time. It is a hundredth of a millionth of a millionth of a second. For comparison, the fastest chemical reaction take about 1,000 femtoseconds, which is 100 times longer. To the right, you see a color table, color codes of atomic charges. For this strong laser pulse, you can obtain up to 39 positive charges per atom, which is marks red. And at the beginning of the laser pulse, all atoms are neutral, charge zero, which means blue. So the white particles are electrons which are pulled off from the atoms. They follow the oscillating laser electric field and are accelerated almost to the speed of light and are carried away from the cluster. What remains are only the positive ions, and because of the like charges, there is such a huge electrostatic repulsion inside the cluster that the whole thing explodes. The ions attain very high kinetic energy, and if you replace xenon by hydrogen isotopes, you can obtain nuclear fusion, a process which happens otherwise in stars. Weaker but longer laser pulse. Because of the lower intensity, we reach charges only up to 21. And not all of the electrons are carried away. Part stay in the cluster. So, how was the computer simulation done, on which the movies are based? In principle, roughly speaking, we know the atomic ionization energies. From this, we can calculate the electric field, which is necessary to pull off the electrons from the atoms, to ionize the atoms. After ionization, the electrons and ions move in the field, electric and magnetic field of the laser, and of all the other ions and electrons. If we calculate the electric field at each electron and ion, we have the forces on each ion and electron. We know the accelerations, the velocities, and we can calculate the entire flight path. For a practical solution, for a practical calculation, we write a computer program, which consists typically of a few thousand or a few 10,000 of lines in C, C++, or Fortran. And the computer simulation runs on powerful computers, needs mostly between a few days and a few months of computation time. Simulations can show details on the atomic level which experiments cannot show. Also, in many cases, experimental results cannot be interpreted without the aid of simulations. On the other hand, simulations contain a lot of approximations and simplifications. And in many cases, we do not know in advance how good an approximation is. So we have to validate the quality of our results with by comparing with the available experimental data. If this comparison is satisfactory, we can rely on our computer model, and we can say that the rest of our predictions are probably also true. So we need both computer simulations and experiment. Together, they are a very powerful tool. Thank you.